Hi everyone and welcome to this new video of the Floss Marketing School. Today I will show a video about how you can know who is the super user of your Matomo instance. So let's get started. Okay, so here we have a Matomo instance and I'm gonna connect to this given instance with a username which is Ellen. So Ellen is trying to connect to Matomo and yes, now she's within Matomo. And as you can see, if she clicks on admin, she will have a menu which is named user. And within the system user menu, she can see a lot of person, but she doesn't have any super user, right? She cannot see who is the super user, and because she's an admin, she may think that actually she has a full control over the Matomo instance, which is not true, because in Matomo you have another user right which is called the super user, and the super user have a control over all the websites which are included within this given instance. Okay, and that's very important because Matomo works per instance compared to other solutions. So here, as you can see, she can just see one website, whereas on this given instance the number of websites tracked may be numerous. So unfortunately, and as you can see, Ellen cannot see who is the super user, and she cannot even guess how many websites they are under this given instance. Actually, if she go within manage, she won't be able to see the other websites which are included within this given instance, whereas there are many others. So to ensure and to allow, let's say, Ellen to be able to see that, she needs to get in contact with the person who installed this, okay, because this person has probably an access to what we call the database. So the database is where all the data which are recorded here through the UI are recorded. So most of the time people will access through the shell like this, right, in SSH or either through a terminal, and they will access to the database. So here we are going to connect to PHP MyAdmin, which is a UI, in order to see what the database look like. But in most of the case, sysadmin will not play with PHP MyAdmin, so will probably play with the shell instead. But we're going to see how it looks like with the UI, because it's more beautiful, so it's maybe easier to explain. So here we have the access to the database. So in my case, those are the username which are not secure at all, but it's just for a demo, so it will be fine. And here, if you go to within this database, you will see that here you have, in my case, several databases of Matomo, but the one I'm interested in is this one, because that's the one of this given instance. And here you have a table which is called Matomo Access, and you probably have another one which is called Matomo User, right? And that's probably the one that you are interested in, because that's the one with listing all the different user, and probably you forgot when you create for the first time your Matomo instance who is the former user. And here, as you can see all the different user which are included within the database. The passwords are encrypted, so that's a good thing, because in some database it's written in full clear, not for Matomo, but let's say for other solutions. So that's the security that Matomo has, so they are encrypted, so you cannot find out what are those given passwords. And if you go on the right, probably you will get the right thing. So super user access, right? You see this column, and here if you go you can see that's known as what we are interested in. And I guess that the reason is that we have a number of rows which are defined by default. So we're gonna go up to 500. And here you can see that there's now some additional lines. So probably if I go over here and I go down the page, I will see that this number one indicates that it's Ronan and it's me who has super user access. Am I right? Yeah, ronantron.com. So if I go over here and I do this, and I connect myself back, and I go here on on Ronan and I validate it, I will get my access to my Matomo instance. So here it's pretty cool because as you can see, I have all the different websites because that's typically what the super user is about, the one who can control all the websites which are included within the instance. And then you can have a look at all the different users which are up here, and that's it, right? You can see everything and you can even see yourself. Oops. Probably I'm on the other page, am I? Yeah, next. Got Ronan, which is over here, which is a super user. And I have as well the possibility to manage all those different websites over here, right? So of course, once you will figure out who is the super user, probably you're gonna forget what is the password over here because you cannot get it back, as it's encrypted, or at least if the different combination that you're going to use are not going to work. You have on the Matomo website documentation the possibility to know what are the different command line you need to execute in order to restart, reboot, let's say, erase this given password and generate another one. And that's it for today. So I really hope that you enjoyed this video. Do not hesitate to try it. Be careful because within the database you can break things. And of course, if you break things and you don't have any backup, you will probably corrupt your database, which means that you won't be able to play with your Matomo data anymore. So please be careful, but as an exercise, try to access to your Matomo's database, see those different users, and try to remember what was the password that you entered formerly. Thanks for watching, and as usual, do not hesitate to create your own video and share them on social networks.